down in the dark where all the fevers grow. Under the water where the shark bubbles blow. In the morning, by a radio, do the walls close in to suffocate you? You ain't got no friends, and all the others they hate you. This is the life you've been leading, gotta go. Well, let me straighten you out. Get your shoes and socks on, people, cause it's right around the corner. Up through the night in the whispering breezes, to the place where they keep the man and the revelation. Up through the night in the whispering breezes, to the place where they keep the man and the revelation. Now scientists call this disease bromidrosis and weldation. But us regular folks who might wear a tennis shoe or an occasional python know this exclusive little inconvenience by the name of snake foot. How true that is. You know, my python boot was too tight. Couldn't get it off last night. A week went by and now it's July. I finally got it off and my girlfriend cried. You got stink foot. Yo, stink foot, darling. Your stinky foot puts the hurts on my nose. Stink foot, stink foot, I lie. Do you rinse it off, do you suppose? Well, here, Fido, here, Fido, bring the slippers, little puppy. Fido, I told you to bring me the slippers.
Oh, man. I was so sore, I couldn't keep them in my mouth.
Fido, when a big person tells a little animal to bring the slippers, and the little animal doesn't bring the slippers, it means the little animal can be punished to the full extent of imperial law.
No shit.
Yes, Fido, I must punish you.
Oh, hurt me, hurt me, hurt me.
Very well then.
Thank you.
God made the light. Shortly thereafter, God made the poodle. When the poodle was first constructed, it was a normal kind of a dog. It had hair evenly distributed all over its tasteful, discreet, compact, dog-like body. This hair was even in length. I'll repeat, even in length. The poodle at that time was respected by other dogs, even admired in some cases, because he was just like the rest of the gang. Then, God made two big mistakes. The first one was man, and the second one was wool man. Actually, he made a third mistake, which was American man, but we won't discuss that now. Now, wool man looketh upon the poodle in its natural state with hair evenly distributed all over his charming body and said to herself, this dog could really get me hot or ripen my peaches, as they say in the trade. But in order to do that, the dog had to be modified. So the woo man turned to the man and said, sucker, go get a job. And the man went out and got a job. And the man got a paycheck. And the man brought the paycheck back to the cave. And the man gave the paycheck to the woo man. And the woo man went out with a paycheck. And the woo man bought a pair of scissors. And the woo man came back to the cave. And she took the scissors. And she clipped upon the poodle. And these are which you can share.
Who's it? Who's it? Who's it?